Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Today, we're playing another game of Total War Warhammer. I'm the Strategy Professor, and we're going to be doing another Greenskins episode right now. Now, I went ahead and did a couple of moves because I forgot to start the VOD, but you didn't miss that much. I was just thinking about how I'm going to deal with this 33 stack of, like, pretty powerful Savage Orc units, and I decided I'm going to try to sandwich them with these three. And I just bought a bunch of Arab boys here and just positioned to try to make a move on him next turn. It's a little bit awkward because he could send both of his armies at in either direction and make me run. So we'll see. And also this dwarf right here is causing problems. Like, obviously he can't beat one of my armies, but he could take a town. So I have to kind of be careful that he doesn't go into my town. Let me see if he wants peace. I just beat him up. No, he doesn't. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of everything here. I think an army ran, like, over here and went into ambush stance or something. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of him. Get rid of all of his things. And I'm going to send him home. I'm going to send him on vacation here. Had a hard fight. Needs to go home. Say hello to his kids for a little while. Should be able to just boot him, right? Yeah, just disband. And that will free up a lot of money. Okay. Now these... I could get rid of one of these armies too and save even more money, but I think I need these to deal with this. So this is a 14 stack with a Wa army, I believe that's what that is. Yeah, so he's got a Wa army, so I'm gonna need to go over there and deal with that. Now I could split these up and send him down here, pick up territory, one of them, but I think it might be more wise to send them both up north. I could have sworn I already did this at the end of another turn, because I was like, I just wanted to move normally so I could recruit units. Maybe that was a different set of circumstances. Okay, so I'm at 79. So if I get up close, I should be able to raid something. What happens if I raid my own land? Okay, so I don't get any money. Enables replenishment access to that. Obedience minus 3. Growth minus 5. Immune to attrition. But you lose all money. So it doesn't... You don't lose a lot of obedience from it. It just costs you a lot of money. It would cost me 2,000 gold if I did that in this region. No way. But I might be able to raid like right here where I'm not making a lot of money. That's still 1,000. The reason that I want to raid is I want to get a Wa army. I just might not be able to do that though. Okay, let's just go ahead and move north. So if both of these combined, I can probably take that army up there. It's still going to be tough. Wasn't there a quest or something where I had to... Goblin big boss over here. So I could put the big boss over there, but he's pretty strong. He's decent in combat, so... I think moving him... over here is probably a good idea. Okay, Mr. Zalgo, thanks for reminding me. Sometimes it's tough because I can't remember what I said in this campaign and what I was doing in the Dwarf campaign in particular, because I have similar territory, at least down south. Okay. I'm getting 3,000 a turn now, so that's good. Okay, so Karakazul. Getting a lot of money. Anything else I get that's... I don't think so. Alright, Iron Rock. Can't build anything there. Need an obedience. Over here. Iron Rock, super dangerous. Now, if he goes for Iron Rock and takes it, then I could potentially dash down here with him and attack with these two armies and kill him. We'll see. I'm kind of trying to bait him with Iron Rock there. Get this thing up here. I mean, I could build growth, but I'm really gated by the cash right now, not the growth. Dragonhorn Mines, probably going down. We'll see.
Ugh, the Greenskin.
Alright, let's go next turn. Yeah, I agree, Dumpling Shakes. Like, the DLCs have been great. People, you know, some people will be like, oh god, by the time the game's finished, it's $200. I'm like, yeah, but it's not gonna be finished for like 3 years. You know, that means you're buying like 4 games over 3 years worth of content. Okay, so he did choose to try to run me down up here, and he's trying to fight me one-on-one, hoping I'll do it. I'm not falling for it. I should be able to run out of his range. Yes. Yeah, I suspected that would happen. I was like, yeah, you know, if you look at it that way, it's like, yes, the total complete game will cost, you know, well north of $100, but that's content that lasts you for years. Most of the times, it gets released slowly over time. So that's what people don't understand. Like, people just want, like, a complete game that's $50 that has hundreds of hours of replayability, and there's some games that are like that, but it's very rare. I mean, if you just want, like, a AAA title that costs $60 that you can beat, you know, in a couple of weeks, there's plenty of those out there. But something like Warhammer has just a ton of replayability. So I don't mind DLC. I know a lot of people hate on it, and they're like, well, why can't they release a complete game? It's like, because they can't fund a complete game. Like, they can't give you all of those things on their budget. Like, it just costs more money to do it. Like, the graphics on this are really, really high for a strategy game. And the intellectual property is really high, too. Okay. Like, it's got a lot of good content. Trying to look and see what's going on here. I should destroy barracks not in capitals because they are a tier 4 max building. It's true and not true. So if I'm going for black orcs, true. But I'm not going for black orcs most of the time in most buildings. But you need barracks in lower tier places, potentially, so that I can just get cheap units. So that I can get, like, orc arrow boys, or just orc boys, or even biggins, eventually, without taking up a slot in the capital. So that's why some places have barracks in off places, because I'm not going to get black orcs there. So, for example, like Karakazul and Kratomen. So I'm only taking it up to tier 2 at the time so that I could get orc boys and orc arrow boys. That's it, because I don't want to get up to black orcs. So sometimes you have to just build things that are not in capitals because you just need cheap units. The same thing here. Like, all of my capital buildings are occupied right now, so I just have a tier 2 in Karakdrorn because I just want orc boys and orc arrow boys, because I also want to be able to get to the boar boys, which are also require tier 4, and the spider, which also requires tier 4, and I need the stunty mine, level 3, which requires tier 4, and I also need the obedience building, because iron rock is too dangerous, and it's probably going to get taken, and I need obedience. So, you're right in the abstract, that in theory, you should always try to put buildings that are tier 4 in your capital, so you can actually unlock their true power, but in actual practice, sometimes you have to make some wonky adjustments depending on what's going on in the game. Okay, so... yeah, I want to get the Black Orcs. The problem is they take 3 turns, and it's just such fast-paced right now. Like, people are just harassing me and hitting me from all sides that I don't have 3 turns to sit down and wait. I don't even really have 2 turns to sit down and wait most of the time. So that's the problem with Black Orcs. They're an awesome unit. I just can't build them. I don't have time. Like, I could... this place can build them right now. I've got the tier 4 in this capital. But I just can't sit there for 3 turns and build them. So I've got all these other problems. Okay. I can't hit him yet. Now, he ran me off here. I can't burrow. Oh, yeah, I can. I can burrow under right there. Just barely. Right there. I would like to recombine here and then go up and fight him. Coming at him from these multiple angles is very risky because, like you saw, he just ran out, chased me away, and then ran back in his little place. Where is this guy? Okay, so he's still recruiting here. Alright, so I think right now I'm just going to have to... am I going to be able to hold this? Okay, I need the obedience right now. I mean, the money's obviously a big deal. I just can't afford a public order catastrophe over here. What? What's all this corruption? Oh, all that vampiric corruption. God. I got it. Okay. Well, we've got to buy that. I'm going to have to burrow under here. Right. Can I go right there? No. Now, I hope he doesn't come up here with those Savage Orcs and start sieging me. He could do that. Okay, so I think I'm going to have to chill here for a turn or two and just wait on him to come back down here to help me out. What's going on over here? Pretty damaged units. I think that's a wall. That might not be a wall, but I think it is. I think it's with that little... I think that's what that means. Maybe not. I mean, he does have, like, actual, like... things. He has items. Now, you can actually sell this pillar of poo for money. So yeah, he burned things, which sucks, but it still gives me a little bit of cash because he had trolls and they just pooped everywhere. These are such low-tech units, but there's a lot of them. I mean, I have... a decent amount of units here. I need like some cavalry or something. I mean, I could maybe do it without cavalry, but it's gonna be tough. They aren't attacking me from the south anymore, I hope. I think these are their last armies. Like, these 5 armies here are probably their last armies. Alright, I'll tell you what. Let's... dash this guy up here so I can start recruiting next turn, and then let's move this guy just normally up here so that I can recruit this turn. I can't recruit much. How much are those? Are 140 each. get a few more units. It's getting expensive. What else? Yeah, we just kind of have to hang out and wait here, I think. Same thing with Grimgore. Now this guy... Why can't I see what's in that dude's army? I could just see it a second ago, I think, if it's the same army, which I think it is. Let's go over here and just see if we can stand, like, right next to him. So I can see what his army is after this turn. Okay, there we go. So he's got three trolls. I mean, that's really scary. Like, that's definitely going to take three armies. I could combine this guy with some of these. I want to get, like, really cool things, you know? I want to get the trolls, I want to get the spider riders, but I have to deal with these savage orcs first and, like, take this territory. And I have to get the obedience under control. Alright, we get another tech here. I need money. Anything that's going to give me money. So I got Doom Divers, which are cool. I think I just have to go for enormous loot cart. Is there anything that's like... like sacking things? Extra range is okay, I guess. Better bowstrings. Now, I am actually using a lot of these archers more than I thought I would earlier on, just because you need archer units. They're not the greatest in the world, but they're okay. And if you get all of these upgrades for them, like 15% reload time, that could help. That's really good. Extra weapon strength. Now, raiding is not always awesome, but it's okay. Post-battle loot's good. Now, I don't know if for Spider Rider, if that includes a Ragnarok Spider also, or if that's just like normal Spider Rider units. I don't know. I probably want that next, because I'm using so many bows. Let's just go for this, because I'm already using so many bows that extra 10% can kind of be a big deal. Okay. All right, I think that's it. Gonna go to the next one. I got really loud all of a sudden. Accidentally hit my volume button, I think. Sorry for the crinkling there. I just need a little something to eat here. Okay, so he's going for Iron Rock, so I might be able to kill him next turn if he occupies it. Now, if he just runs back to his little town, I'm going to be mad. I think he burned it. I guess that's a small price to pay for killing him next turn. It's still very annoying, though. Interesting. So I intercepted him in the underground. He might be trying to reinforce his other army. So I have him caught out. I don't think this guy has the good magic yet. He does not have the good magic yet. So he still kind of sucks until he gets the Wah spell. Or whatever that spell is. It just... Here we go. That's it. I don't have a lot of... I mean, my chariot's going to be real good here. Is this guy on a flying mount yet? I don't remember. I don't think he is. He does have some nice items. He's kind of hurt. I think we can probably do this. The trolls are... The trolls and the boar are pretty scary, honestly. Especially those boar. But... I think my archer units can probably deal with them. Surely he's on a normal boar. Can't really tell. I think we can beat this. So if I don't catch him, it runs. I don't know where he is or what he's doing. Like, he might be trying to reinforce that army. It just burned my town. I know it looks like I have a lot more numbers, but the problem is they have legendary stats and they have higher tech units. They have trolls that are extremely good because they get huge leadership bonuses on legendary. And the Savage Orc Boar Boys. So I'm going to have to be able to shoot down these trolls before they get anywhere close to me. And then try to nullify the Boar Boys with something. I don't... Like, maybe have my Lord face tank it. With fireballs. And just keep my trolls away from these things. And then try to use the chariot to either countercharge... the boars, or to charge into these things and just use my doom divers to try to mess with their air boys. I don't know, it's gonna be a really hard fight, but I guess I'll try it out. If I lose, then I lose the level 15 lord, which sucks, and my shaman. Now, there's not much of a penalty of just letting him go, I guess. Then I can combine and fight next turn with all three. I'm going to do it, though. I want the challenge. Even though this didn't work out so well for us last time. I just like taking on tough fights sometimes. And this will be a tough fight. Alright, we're going to gamble that. Alright, nice. Alright, so we've got a rain dude here. This Ed Butt can disrupt formation. I think we're still just gonna cast Fists of Gork. We'll probably cast those on just some orc boys. I can't overcast that, right? Is that what the deal is? No, can't overcast it. Alright. So we're gonna have to control the flanks here. I think we want to be like over here, kind of in this corner. Alright. So we want to make these like out here in this four group and just put them in skirmish mode. These will be my two group for flankers, five for the doom divers. Uh, Now, I could get out here in front if I want to throw some Gaze of Morks. I just don't think that's good. I just don't think it's a good use of my magic. I'd rather spend it on Fist of Gork. Maybe even Edbutt just to, like, knock stuff over, if possible. Like, if boars are charging me or something, I could use Edbutt to, like, knock them back. Maybe, I don't know. Wait, no. These things are their own thing. Group 3. There we go. Now, are they going to come at me, or are they going to make me walk at them? It looks like they're going to make me walk at them. Okay. So, yeah, we just want to try to use, like, this edge here to our advantage. Just so they can't flank us with those boars. So I just want to form, like, kind of like a triangle shape. Get them to commit and then try to flank them with the trolls. Now, their trolls are the number one things that we need to try to deal with. Try to do some close-ups whenever I can. I'm really more on the deeper strategy side rather than kind of the cosmetic, like, cool-looking side, cinematic stuff. I just don't have time in some of the fights that are just really tough to do that. I try to do that because I've had people request that. Can I do more close-ups and things of battles? But sometimes some of these fights that I get into are just so hard that... I mean, you've seen I lose fights, like, sometimes because I take very unsafe fights sometimes just to... add a little extra spice to the channel and just give a little bit extra challenge so you just don't know that I'm going to cakewalk everything. Can I get some shots in before their arrows shoot me? I don't know if I'm going to be able to outrange them or not, but we're going to try. Nope. Back him up. You get the trolls. Aim for these boar. Nice. Yeah, get him. If they just want to charge our enemy like that, I'm cool with that. What the heck? I guess I forgot about him. What? That was so far off. Alright, get out of there. Get out. Dude, get over here. Kill those trolls. Alright, these guys kind of rallied back. Yeah, Yeah, this is not looking good. Those boars and the trolls are just so strong. War chariot, get out. Go over here, get those. Like, forget the... Okay, so I did get the trolls. Run, 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 and run. We're kind of doing sort of okay over here. Alright, let's just go ahead and try to knock some of those over. Guys, run. Alright, shoot these boar. Oh god. Oh, my dude's running. Oh, this might be the end of him. Savage Orcs are just so strong. Stick in there. Run, run, run. Get over here. Help him. I cannot fight Savage Orcs unless I have just like huge numbers. Well, this is gonna be another big defeat. Yeah, I cannot fight Savage Orcs unless I have a huge, like, just huge numbers. Like, those boars are just way too strong. So there goes a 14 or a level 15 orc war boss. So that sucks. I should just let him go underground. Now, Savage Orcs are no joke on Legendary. Yeah, so they baited me. I should have just let it go. And then I could have had both of these armies fighting him. Maybe not. No, I couldn't have had both this turn. His other army is... That secondary army is banged up, though. Jesus. Well, I'm gonna have to back up over here. Gonna have to burrow him under over here and just try to meet up like right here and fight. I do have enough money now where I could hire some spiders and some higher tech stuff over here. Okay, as soon as that finishes, I think we might stabilize. I hope. We'll see. Alright, so we've got these bloody hands over here. Now rebels. What? They have like 32 units over here. Like really high tech stuff. I think I'm just gonna have to give them all this. They're gonna get it, and I'm just gonna have to sit here. And these guys are hiring up some new stuff too, just right in the middle of my territory. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to, like, just go prime time here. Just quit playing around, sit here. I'm just gonna have to suck it up and just hire a bunch of black orcs, I think. Black orcs should destroy savages. I think. They should do quite well against them. Maybe Biggins might be better, actually, because they have a lot of boars and trolls, and that's what I'm scared of most. And Biggins only take two turns, and they're a lot cheaper. a lot cheaper on upkeep, so maybe it's Biggins that I should be going for. Doomdivers are pretty good too, but they're pretty expensive. Doomdivers aren't as good against... they're good against Savage Orcs for sure, but they're really a lot better against things like Dwarves and Empire and things that have better missile units. I mean, the Black Orcs are undeniably super strong. They have so much armor. And armor piercing, but the armor piercing doesn't matter against Savage Orcs because they don't have any armor to begin with. So you don't really gain a lot of benefit out of their armor piercing. You would gain a benefit out of this bonus to large, though. Alright, let's just crank out some Biggins here. With him. Then with this guy. I don't know, what else can we hire here? I guess we could just hire some more just normal orc boys. I guess we can wait on it just so we don't pay the upkeep. Just hang on, just since I have to wait two turns anyway, and then next turn I can just hire a whole boatload. I need to hire, like, some big gun stuff over here, too. Like, this is... this at least has some boar in it. And it has a goblin. I mean, that sneaky stab and an itchy nuisance is going to be tremendous in a fight. I would really like to get a spider over here and some more boars also. But I just can't hire this turn. I'm afraid they're going to come over and interrupt me. I'm going to look at my building situation. I mean, I don't think we're in danger of losing the campaign or anything. We have definitely lost some tough battles, and that's going to set us back, but we still have quite a lot of territory. And the Savage Orcs are just our biggest threat right now. We're just gonna have to let it go. God, what do you want, dude? Are you gonna declare war on me again? Bunch of trolls. Now I'm super. They must be about to die. This says my like my strength rating's off the charts. They're not even like anywhere close to me. Sure, whatever. Maybe someone paid him to do it. Okay, these dwarfs are kind of helping me out a little bit. Interesting. Okay. Well, now I can surround him with three armies. I don't think I want angry gods. I think it'll like give you earthquakes and stuff sometimes if you do that. Well, they think they're scavengers, Mr. Zalgo, but what they don't know is I think they might have just walked into a trap. I'm pretty sure I can attack them with three armies right now, including Grimgore. We'll see. Alright, so... yeah, I think I've got to do a tribute. I don't like giving away free money, but I just can't risk, like, a huge public order spike in one of my places right now. I just can't deal with rebellions. So we're just going to do a tribute. Oh no, my units are pretty far away. Can't tell how far I can dash. No... they're moving just strategically enough. to be like extremely annoying. I don't have lightning strike, I don't think. No. Should have gotten lightning strike instead of this stupid crap up here. Wound maker and Ard lads and all this stuff. If I would have just had lightning strike instead, it'd be a very different story. I could lightning strike out this 11 stack. Yeah, I'm gonna have to let him get Valia Sorrow, I think, and then finish this. Hire more units here. And then we're gonna collapse on him, I hope, and kill him soon. So he's gonna burn Valia Sorrow, probably. Sucks, but I just can't fight him right now. He's like just out of range every time. And I can't move this guy because he's already recruiting here. So that's fine. I mean, they're digging their own grave here. They're just doing as much damage as they can. But really, you know, it's only going to take me a few thousand gold. Yeah. A few thousand gold to repair all this. So it's not like a huge game-breaking deal. Now, this rebel... Okay, good. I did solidify this up here. So this is green now. So that's good. That province is giving us a lot of money. So I'd love to extort it and get more money out of it, but I've got to at least wait until this corruption dies down a little bit here. Trending towards 36, what? Oh, the osmosis is 4? Jesus. Alright, let's just go down here. Now, this army's still banged up. They're not replenishing that much at all. They have like a little bit of replenishment, but... These two armies... should be able to beat their two armies. Because we have a goblin. Not, these things are so powerful. The night goblins are just so instrumental. Anytime you want to win a fight, they are just huge, huge, huge. So I think these two can win a fight. And I think if he burns Valia Sorrow, I'm going to get to surround him. And I think these two can win a fight with him. So either one of these like flanks should be able to win a fight. Then I can use all four of these armies and just steamroll them down here. Once I get them all in one place. The problem is I've just been so spread out with so many armies. But once I can sandwich these two in, I hope. Once they go to take out Valia Sorrow, I should be able to sandwich them in, kill them, and then push them down this way. And knock out everything they have down here. I hope. And then we can just start restructuring, building everything, and just working our way back up north. But because we don't really have any other like scary enemies at war with us right now. Warriors of Chaos are obviously scary, but I don't think they're close. No, they're up here. They're on the scary side. I mean, Kirakiran. Come then, messenger. We've already beaten up one of their armies. Empire is not at war with us. They're over here doing their thing. We don't even know where Bretonnia is yet. The Border Princes are not really a problem. Savage Orcs have killed everything but one province. So it's really just the Savage Orcs that are a big deal. And I think this is like all of their armies. So if I just kill these and work down here, I should be able to clean them out. So I think we're still in a good place, even though we've, you know, lost a couple of armies in this campaign. No repairs. Let's see what time it is. I can't remember when I started this. I think we're getting close to time, but I do want, like, a redemption fight here. Yeah. It's going for maximum annoyance. They'll probably burn it. I mean, raising is annoying, but at least it doesn't cause a lot of public order problems in the rest of the province. Was that a third army coming over here? That would actually make it a little... That's a little more challenging. But I think that third army is going to be too late. Yeah, it's too small. It's too little, too late. I think we're going to kill him. He can't take care of Cape Peaks because that is... a capital. with walls. So I should be able to... They can't really burrow under. Okay, so I can go, like, right... Now, what he could do is try to burrow under and go for this stuff over here if he really wants to. So I need to get to, like, right here, probably. Yeah, on it. This way, I should be able to dash under over here, I think, and support, and use both of these armies just to go, like, right here. And I'm pretty sure we can beat him up if I go right here. Hire a couple units. I wasn't that impressed. I misused that chariot in the last battle, but wasn't super impressed with it either way. Go for a couple of Spider Riders. I mean, these are okay units. They're pretty good. They're pretty good for, like, flanking, and just one turn is all it takes to make them, and they're very cheap. Very, very cheap for cavalry. Okay, I think we've got a good surround going here. So if he goes under, I think we'll be able to fight him. We do not want to fight him one-on-one in the tunnel. This army might actually be able to fight him one-on-one in the tunnel. This army, probably not. Okay, what else? Oh, I forgot about this dude last turn. I need to roll him down here. I needed to put him with one of these armies, because he's a pretty good wolf fighter. Yeah, the evening seems to be a bad time of day for League. Or, like, right now, because a lot of the Europeans are asleep. They're not League for Total War Warhammer. I might play some League here in a second, actually. I'm super tired, but at the same time, I was on a hot streak earlier today, and I just kind of want to play a couple more games. I don't know if I'll stream those or not. I'll see. Maybe I should just go to sleep. I don't know. We'll see. Alright, I think,
the tribe's ready.
I think that's going to be good. And check out buildings. I think there's a lot extra I could do with the buildings that I wanted to do. No. I mean, I could upgrade this to tier 3, which would be good. What's that, 300 for 4,000? So it would be 10, 13, about 18 turns. The public order is declining, however. Could upgrade one of these. That's very expensive for my taste right now. You're right, Mr. Zalgar. They should get up and start watching. We're going to have to call him up. Get him on Skype. Get up. Get on stream. Okay, I think... I'm just not sure if I can hold this right now. We've got so many forces dedicated down south. The corruption is falling, but it's... very slowly falling because of all this osmosis. I guess I'll go ahead and invest in it. More income's good. I am gonna need money to refurbish these places. They're just getting trashed though. Yeah, they dropped dragon Horn Mine and started running over here to try to help their friends because they know they're gonna die. They done goofed getting too aggressive with me. Now what could actually happen is these rebels, I've seen this happen before, these rebels will actually attack this other unit because they're in the way. So maybe, maybe not, but they could possibly weaken some of these units. Alright, let's call it a turn. As soon as we get revenge on these other two, one way or another, we'll figure it out. Oh, don't mess with me, man. Did he just seriously kill Ozog? He better not have assassinated Ozog right there, that stupid dwarf. Okay, so they fought the rebels off. And the rebels probably did some kind of damage there. Alright, so they're gonna try to backline me here. I will eventually track these clowns down and kill them. Okay, so they just assaulted some units. It's annoying. Okay, so we should be able to fight him, I think. Hopefully. Now this might be one of those areas where it's like a super narrow pass and I can't do it. I think I can.
This way. Azog is here.
He's probably gonna run, but we're gonna try. Oh. Okay. I'm gonna auto resolve this. Just because, I mean, it's. He got my garrison too. It's like a zillion units. Like I have more than a 3-to-1 advantage on him. So I'm just going to auto-resolve it. I would like to... I mean, I'm tempted to manually do it just to physically get revenge and kill them all. But I don't want to waste time. It's a pretty obvious outcome, I think. Yeah, we just kind of pinned them in. There's no way they're getting out of that alive. Now, they do still have a 20 stack sitting there, so... You know, we're not quite out of the woods yet. I need to do some more XCOM also, but the XCOM, I have to be, like, wide awake, alert, and ready to go. Because just, like, one misstep, one slight misclick, and that's it for the whole campaign. It's by far, I think, the most challenging, strategically challenging thing that I'm doing in terms of zero, like, room for error. I guess League is kind of like that, too, if you're really trying to improve and get to Diamond. I really can't ever make mistakes. Okay, so I got Prime Mover. Should I... Yeah, I don't really need this other stuff, that's the thing. So even though these aren't that great, I just don't need anything past Itchy. I mean, Sneaky's okay. Visor's okay. This will be better later in the game once we start moving up into Chaos territory. We need to clean all that out. I think I'll do Thumped. Oh, I can actually continue on an attack. Can't I? I thought it said someone... Oh, no, it was him. He could run over there and do something to him if I wanted to. Can I attack him with garrison help? Can the garrison attack him? Now I have to be, like, in the garrison. I thought before I've seen it to where the garrison can't attack people. Okay. Well. Ready for murdering. Okay, I need to retake Vallea Sorrow. Can this guy beat him? 18 on 18. I don't want to really devote a lot of units to trying to fight this if I don't have to. I'll figure it out next episode. I think that's going to be it for this episode. Let me see how long it's been. Hey, Toric. I think this episode might be really long. I don't know. I may have lost track of time. How many episodes did I do before? I think I just did one before, right? Yeah, I think this has been a pretty long episode. Okay, well, thank you very much for watching. Yeah, Torek said that I might be too far away. Well, the garrison just supported me with a previous, with that previous fight, and it also had the yellow arrow when I tried to click on the guy with my unit, so I don't know. I think they're in range. I'm not really sure what the deal is, but anyways, that's going to be it for this Greenskins episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You know, once again, I took on a really tough battle against the Savage Orcs in the Underground. It didn't work out so well. So the moral of the story is just do not fight those Savage Orcs, especially in the Underground, unless you have like some serious firepower. Like, you really need to outgun them to have a chance, because just the scaling with the Savage Orcs on Legendary is really hardcore. So anyways, that's going to be it. If you're waiting on the next Greenskin campaign episode, please be sure to check out the rest of the campaigns. They're all a lot of fun. I have every campaign on Legendary, no auto-resolve abuse, except for Chaos. We will do Chaos eventually. Not right now. I'm doing an XCOM 2 series. And that's going to be on Iron Man Legendary. So no takesies backsies. If somebody dies, they're actually dead. You can't ever go back. It's just like Legendary for Warhammer, so it makes it very, very challenging. And then I'm also doing Civ 6 Deity Mode, and I'm going to do no takesies backsies there either. I don't know if Deity Mode forces you to auto-save it, but if it doesn't, then I'm going to auto-save it. So I pledge not to go back on any turns or save scum or any of that stuff. And I think that's it. Yeah, Civ 6, XCOM 2, League of Legends as well. I'm trying to get to Diamond by only playing support every single game. So I just try to do it with good strategic thinking. So that's a lot of fun. It's an interesting challenge. So check out all that stuff. We have a ton of content on the channel. And I also do multiplayer battles for Total War Warhammer as well. I haven't done as much of those lately. I want to get back into it eventually. I just got a little frustrated and kind of burned out with some of the abuses and mechanics in multiplayer. It is a lot of fun, but especially flying units are pretty imbalanced in multiplayer, but I'm hoping they'll change that with this new patch. We'll see. But anyways, thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Have a wonderful evening.